I am innocent, and the truth matters. I know the system doesn't care about me.
But you didn't deserve what happened to you.
Now, you may have heard the name Brian Banks, but not the whole story.
He was a 16-year-old boy who was being pursued to play football at USC when he was wrongfully accused of rape and convicted. Now, his incredible story has been made into the movie Brian Banks in theaters Friday.
Go see that.
Greg Kinnear stars as the lawyer who took his case.
Here was all front and center an example of somebody being wrongly accused in the worst possible way.
Brian Banks was 16 years old when he was accused of a crime he did not commit.
I couldn't have imagined losing 10 years of my life, but I'm here.
The real Brian helps produce the film that Tom Shodiak directs. After being falsely accused of rape, Brian entered an innocent plea, but then was given only two choices, neither good. Either take a plea deal or risk life in jail. Sherry Shepherd plays Brian's mother.
The judicial system failed him tremendously. His career, his life was taken from him.
He was sentenced to 5 years behind bars and a few more on parole. The case got the attention of Justin Brooks, co-founder of the California Innocence Project, who fought in favor of Brian and won. As for the girl who put Brian behind bars, she finally admitted she lied.
How did you survive it?
Almost did. The only thing that I could say that's very, unique about my story is that I was exonerated.
And he's thriving. He's a father to 7-month-old Orion, and he did fulfill his NFL dreams playing for the Atlanta Falcons. And now Brian is determined to pay it forward.
These are real life issues. I have to represent others who can't represent themselves.
Much like Kim Kardashian, who has already worked to free over 15 inmates in her fight for criminal justice reform. The most recent, Santoya Brown, released this morning.
Kim has black children as well. So to look at her children and go, say, might go through something like this, or my daughter might go through something like this, gives her more of an empathy for her children who are biracial.
I think that anyone who takes their platform, their brand, and everything that they worked so hard to achieve and use that as a tool to help those who cannot help themselves, I commend her, I commend her family. And I'm hoping that you see this film and in some ways want to be involved in it because we could use all the help that we can get spreading this message.
Kim, this is a plea.
Yeah, come work with us.
If you love that video, you're going to love everything on the Access YouTube channel. So hit the subscribe button. You can thank me later. Hit it. Now.